What's up, YouTube, and welcome to the top 10 new metal riffs of all time. All right, let's get down to it. Woohoo! We're not actually going to do that today. That's ridiculous. I'm not going to do that today. A year ago, I started a Patreon account. You may remember the video of me walking around in a silk robe, shaving my legs and doing all sorts of things to get attention, basically. That's pretty much what I'm doing again now, a year later. Now, I can't believe the amazing support I've received on Patreon the last year. It's been absolutely incredible. It's literally enabled me to carry on doing what I love, which is music, putting out stupid content, stupid videos, and I'm gonna give you an insight to that now, because a lot of people have been asking me, hey Andy, you do great vlogs, we love your vlogs, what happened? Where do they go? Every single month I do an exclusive vlog for Patreon. That's been happening for a year now. If you haven't seen any, I'm gonna show you a little montage now of my favorite parts. Just signing up to the $5 tier will give you access to all those previous vlogs. There's 12 of them, and they're about 30 to 45 minutes long each, so there's a lot of content. Backlog of vlogs, that's tricky to say. There is a ton of exclusive content accessible through Patreon, and the reason it's on there is because I need to make a living, I need to pay bills just like anyone else does, I need to make albums, I need to fund them somehow, and this is the absolute best way to support me. There's no reason to be shy or be ashamed about that. Thank you so much, anyone who's supporting me on there, has done for the last year. You guys are awesome. I want to continue building that community with you guys. We have a Discord. We're in there. We're chatting every single day. We're posting memes. People can post their own projects in the Discord and we can all chip in and help out with the music you guys are creating too. It's a collaborative process. We're doing a Patreon song collab right now where all the patrons and myself are writing a song together. It's super fun. I do monthly live streams where I do songwriting masterclasses, which is awesome. Super fun to hang out. There's tons of other perks as well. You can see them all in the description below. Even for the $1 tier, you will get early access to all my videos. If you sign into the $5 tier on Patreon now, for example, you will get not only the vlogs going forward, you will get 12 vlogs going backwards. You can see all the previous vlogs. I mean, that's a no-brainer, right? You sign up, you get all the old vlogs. There's 12 of them because there's 12 months in a year. You do the math, all right? A year on, I would like to celebrate the anniversary. I just looked right into that light, and now I can see hexagons everywhere. Hexagons. Are they hexagons or are they octagons? Or are they septagons? There's a lot of weird shapes going on in here now. This is quite a trip, yeah. So thank you. A few more patrons, maybe I can fix this f***ing chair. And I'm gonna celebrate this anniversary right now with a best of recap of the year we've just had, of all the vlogs. Those vlogs are, they're still going. I'm still doing vlogs, you know? Still out here doing vlogs. So, you know, you like my studio diaries, you like my tour diaries, you're gonna like these monthly vlogs, okay? All right, let's roll that videotape. Imagine. All right, let's roll the videotape and, I'm gonna leave that in. No, I'm not. If I mention Australia a lot in this vlog, it's because I moved to Australia from Britain. I am still British. I don't think you lose that. I think that's something that stays with you. Fucking chair, do you hear that? I need a fucking new chair. It's supposed to be a 2-minute intro. It's gone out the window. Hello, that chair! Anyway, let's get on with this. This is a montage of the recap of the best of the stuff of the thing with the Patreons for the last year. Thank you so much for supporting me there. And let's watch it. Let's do the thing. Put the videotape on. All right, put in the VCR. Yeah, that's how you do it. You put the tape on, roll the tape, roll the VT. All right, that's it from me, guys. Thank you so much. And I'm gonna roll that videotape now. Videotape. All right, that's it from me. Thank you so much, guys. I'm gonna roll the videotape now. Videotape. And if you do feel like supporting me on Patreon, check out the link below. It really means a lot and it really will go a long way. It's not really a commitment, is it? You can opt out whenever you want. You sign up and watch all the old backlog of stuff and then piss off again. No pressure. But would love to see you there. Thanks a lot. All right, enough of this intro. I think it's gone on probably long enough. Can still see those hexagons. Put that tape on, all right? It's what you missed out on. Catch you later. See you on the next one, guys. Cheers.
There'll be music, explosions, and even a kangaroo. There's a hammock, a guitar, I'll share it all with you. Random appearances from people you might know. I actually have no idea what's gonna be in the show. If it's a disaster, I'll have to get a job. Everyone's invited to the Patreon exclusive monthly fucking blog.
Unless you're not a patron.
Blue ring octopus, great white shark, Ikaranji jellyfish. Just some of the things that can kill you out here in Melbourne, Australia.
Water spiders, electric eels.
Wait, there's water spiders.
Swimming koalas.
What, seriously? There's...
It's possible.
Okay. Okay, I'm gonna head back.
Water spiders.
God, look at this.
This may look harmless, but make no mistake, this is as deadly as they come.
It's the broccoli of the sea, they call it. What it does is it swims into your balls. It wraps itself around your ball sack, squeezes your testes, and injects its children into your sphincter. Now, I won't get any closer than this.
My foot just touched something.
I said, I think my new computer's arriving today. Fucking can't wait. I'm gonna beat my horn, I'm so excited. And release. All right, and that's what it's all about. Taking the bad energies and releasing them back to the world.
Thank you.
See you. Have a good day, eh?
Scaffold.
Yes, this new soundproofing has arrived in the studio. Oh, got this matte finish. This is the Active oscillating reciprocal utilizer speed. So it's a real quick one, that one. Ultra as well, so ultra.
Little car, picture of a car on it. It just basically means it's gonna be fast.
Got some more air bags there, that's good, isn't it? Some more soundproofing going on. We don't want it to be loud computer, so we got them ones.
Holy shit, the fucking fan. It's fucking massive. What the fucking hell's going on there?
I don't understand what's happened there. That's really big.
A cheeky power supply.
Gold plus, don't f around there. 10-year warranty, 850. The thing about the RMX series is, it's high performance. 100% all Japanese capacitors as well. So that's good.
Oh, definitely.
It's high performance, premium components, and low noise, which is essential.
Bada boom, bada bing.
CPU's gonna be faster.
Faster than,
the last one.
Faster than the last one, yeah. What am I gonna do with all the air?
There's a lot of air that came with this. Did not order that, actually. You might have to let them know. Ken.2, you don't wanna mess around with that. These things are fucking expensive, I tell thee.
Oh my fucking god, there's a fucking massive huntsman. It's the first time it's happened. I think it's a baby. Okay, we need to do something about this. Oh, it's trying to get in the car. Babe, it can't get in that car. I cannot have that going in my car. Babe, just give me in the bucket.
If I lose in the car, I'm never driving again.
No, Andy, that's never fitting.
I'm putting it on him.
That's never fitting.
Give me the broom. I'm going to go one sweeping movement.
Oh, I think this is a bad idea. This is essentially curling. We're going to have to...
This is curling a spider, yeah.
Yeah.
If I just brush that way...
Can I get in the car and drive out?
Drive the car out. Driving a spider away.
Yeah.
On the drive to get him away from that's how big it is. Take him away.
He's gone. I can't see him. Has he gone in the car? Okay, oh, he's there. He's on the floor, I see him running.
All those years practicing sweeping paid off, eh?
The video game style metal album. Just give you a little bit more. What have we got here? Don't want to give too much away. Right.
Fucking hello, mates. What's going on?
It's alright. Jesus, man.
Sorry, that was right in your ear, wasn't it?
Here in your kitchen with your boy, Papa Dom Master, yeah! Papa Dom, gotta cat fry them all. That's so true. They go well with Vindaloo.
Ananda is cable tying Theo. This may look like a sexual act. It's not that at all.
There is a hack. It's a big life hack for anyone out there.
Hold it up like that and you smash it down. So it's helpful if the join is at the top. Lift it up above your head and then smack it down.
I just whack it.
Yeah. Any of you are ever in this position, this is how you get out, apparently.
I'm ready.
Ow!
It fucking worked!
Ow! I didn't hit that. Oh! Oh, it's still connected.
Don't ever tell me that this show is not educational, because it is. It is. Do the jingle.
It's the Molly educational part of the show.
Colt, Spencer, Nessa, Simon, and why are you always in caps lock? That's not fair. Ryan Huttonens, thank you, my friend. Jack Thomas Barker, Arjen, Takine, Edward, Brose. Raise a glass now to all the people who supported this Patreon and continue to do so, and keeping Larry in business, I'll say that much. Larry was docile for a number of years
5 or 6 years. You've brought me back from retirement, and I really appreciate it.
All right, so this is where the magic happens. All my merch stored in here. All the t-shirts up here, it's all done from home. All the orders that are sent out from my little studio with the help of Ananda as well. She helps with everything. God bless her, couldn't do it without her. An order from Japan for a bundle. So I thought I'd film this and show you guys everything's done from here. Socks in here. That's where the socks live. Every order gets one of these little thank you cards. And I like to write a little message on there. Personalized message to make everyone feel special. I think everyone should feel special. Grab one of the albums and do a quick quality check on every single one. Make sure that it's not too scuffed up. A couple of these had like a couple of scuffed up edges and I was not happy about it. And then I know it sounds stupid, but I turn the album around so that it's perfect. I take great pride. This is the second to last small I've got, so I'm going to have to order some more of these. All the smalls are gone. Sign every CD that goes out. And then this is the best part of the whole thing, is I just give this to Ananda and it just somehow fits in this envelope and gets sent off to Japan. I don't know what happens there. Talking with my buddy T. Lopez, who is the composer for Sonic Mania, collabing on a video game cover. We're doing Star Fox. Maybe, something like that. Yeah.
What? Penis?
Oh yeah, he's got an erection there.
I'm not gonna help you. I'm just gonna watch.
I thought I'd take everyone through my modest setup, get everything done with just this. All you need is a sock. Keyboard is optional. I built it just before Embers of the Dying World, and that was recorded on this PC with pretty much a setup like this.
RME Babyface Pro FS, which in all honesty kicks the shit out of what I had before, which was the Focusrite.
And these are the headphones I use. The Audio-Technica
M50X.
This like sort of rubber black stuff comes off in your ears. My ears are full of that now. So I should probably get some new headphones at some point. My guitar plugs into one of these normal guitar leads and that runs into a Countryman DI. The reason we have the DI box is to give us the option later to change the guitar tone should we wish. Picks up the dry signal of the guitar and sends it out the back to the RME, which sends it to your computer. But at the same time, this DI signal comes out of this purple cable and goes into the AXFX, which comes out from an XLR at the back and goes into the RME as well. So you just play once and you get two different signals. I then have the option. I can use my AXFX tone, which is usually pretty good. Or if I want to reamp it later, we then just play what I played into an amp. God, look at the dust on this. This is disgusting. I'm so sorry, guys. This is absolutely disgusting. I'm going to refilm all of this.
My mascot, Sonic, Super Sonic, though. It's got all the emeralds. Got the album there, sitting there to remind me, you know, what I've managed to achieve. And when you're 3 years into a project, don't give up because you know that it could end up looking like that eventually when it's done.
A very simple setup. I get a lot of comments. People question how I can do a big album release with just a simple setup like this, but you do not need a big studio these days. You just need a good computer and you need to know what you're doing and you can make a world-class sounding record.
Is that a joke?
I mean, we haven't tried it with the guitar yet. I don't know how that's gonna...
Oh!
Do it for the gram! It's causing me crippling back pain right now. Giving way too much away here, but I am so f***ing psyched about this album.
You had your f***ing chance, my dulcet tones, and he said, mate, you're doing my f***ing Patreon.
This is my f***ing gig, mate.
F*** I don't need this shit. F*** off, Larry.
I'm never going to be able to see my kids again.
F*** off.
Larry's back, bitches.
I know, I have to clean the drums now. You know, I have to sponge it down. You have to really get in there. I haven't had a chance to set it up yet.
I need to clean it before I set it up.
Cobwebs all over these damn things. Probably spiders.
What is that?
What is that? Who knew you had to clean electric drum kits with a sponge?
Well, now you do.
White walkers are coming and we need to clean our drum kit. We have to clean them.
A lot of the sand of a drum kit actually comes from the cleaning that goes on beforehand.
Like Michael Caine.
You are only supposed to clean the bloody cymbals. You've gone, Master Chris, and cleaned the China cymbals and the ride cymbal, even the hi-hats. I didn't tell you to clean the hi-hats, all right? Next, you'll be cleaning my bloody toms.
It took some time to do that.
Exhausted, but it's looking good.
Well, right now, I just have a bunch of poles.
Starting to look like a drum kit already.
There are a lot of parts missing.
Ah!
There is a spider.
There he is.
He's in the snare drum.
Alright, let's get this show on the road then, people. It's got to cover the nose and mouth, apparently.
Alright, let's do it!
One does not simply walk into a party dressed as Boromir!
The beard is a bit much. I'll trim that. I could have been Gimli. We're looking pretty similar, I would think.
She's made the Horn of Gondor.
Is that a McDonald's cup? Cue the beard shaving montage!
Pretty even.
You happy with that?
It looks like someone skinned a ferret.
It looks like someone's just waxed a badger.
Last minute preparations, we're leaving in less than an hour probably. And Nanda is absolutely killing it. The McDonald's straws, I spray painted them black. It's Bernie f***ing Sanders! It's Bernie Sanders!
For the Shire!
For the Shire!
Don't get the arrows in his face, holy shit!
Leave it to me!
It's Friday. It's the album launch day for the new Mons Principia Mest album. It's a pretty big deal, pretty big day. Ah, blimey. Hard to explain, really, the feeling. It was an incredibly intense project. It's like raising children, you know, and then seeing them go out into the world and be appreciated by other people and being able to share that with the fans is why I do it. On top of the years of writing it, then all the putting it together and recording it, I was burnt out. Spending a night in hospital, crazy rash all over my body. I was shivering uncontrollably, felt like I had hypothermia, and I couldn't stop shaking. My heart rate was through the roof. I actually have some photos and videos that I haven't released I might put into this vlog for you guys to check out. It's actually really horrible. One where my face is really swollen up to the point I could barely see out of my eyes. So horrible to look back on. Had this rash for a couple of weeks. It wouldn't go away. If I thought about the album, the rash would come back. It was really quite harrowing to see your body change like that. Under pressure. And I've had a lot of people come to me and say that they've had this hives outbreak when they've been under tremendous stress, and that's what happened to me. So I spent the night in hospital. They couldn't find anything wrong with me other than it was this stress-related onset of hives. I got home and I was trying to rest up and I knew I had to write more lyrics. So it was a very trying time to get this album done before the deadline. You know, it's unthinkable now when I look back at that. I still feel that exhaustion from putting this together. It's a very lonely experience, really. So to then get the reward at the end of the comments from you guys who've bought the album or just listened to the album or whatever, it's really rewarding to hear that the time and effort that went in wasn't in vain and that people are getting some enjoyment, especially this year when we all really need it.
Okay, there's a situation. I'm just gonna come out with it. This is the world's biggest moth.
Australia, Australia, it's a fucking terrifying place to live.
And it's in the cupboard, and I don't know what we're gonna do about it. I'm not kidding, this thing is, it looks like a bat. Oh my god, it's massive. It's on my bottle of tawny. I don't know what I'm gonna do. Oh my god, I don't even think that's a moth. I don't know what it is. No, it's not a moth. It's like a praying mantis or something with, I think it's shedding. I hate this country. Why did we move here? What is that?
Eagle God!
You f***ing hit me with a feather duster. Sorry. Camera, we're gonna find out what this f***ing thing is. Oh my god. I think it might be a cockroach having sex with a massive white thing. What is that? This is me signing off to just say, don't move to Australia. Just don't do it. Feels good to be back, Chris.
It's not gonna feel good after, it's gonna hurt.
Oh, yes. So what does this one do?
It does a noise. Then this one does another noise I like.
Yeah. Is that this one? This one's white noise. Yeah.
That's white noise. Yeah. So that's more of like the shh. Yeah. Sound. And that's black noise. So that's more of like the.
Okay.
Sound.
Yeah.
That was my favorite noise.
Is that the brown noise?
Ever.
Which one's the brown?
The Marshall.
The orange noise.
It's the Marshall. They always make the brown noise.
Look, I broke this. Do you want to tell them about that story? Look, dude, come on, man. Those bolts were rusty when you gave me it.
You managed to break one of the bolts on the Floyd Rose.
I was covering Children of Bodom, and we are still going to do that, aren't we? That cover.
I'm actually about to finish mixing it.
Oh, yeah, we'll let them in. I'm letting you guys in. We're doing a Children of Bodom cover.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome. It's
going to be fucking sick.
I forgot these brakes don't work. Fuck.
21 gears, only two of them work, so it's not a lot of give and take with that. And it does change gears without you knowing. Chain comes off almost every kilometer. But she's my trusty steed. $150 from Kmart, not a bad job. I saw a koala bear up here and I'm looking for it again. So that would have been quality content right there, guys. Keep looking out for snakes. Very dry and warm, and these danger noodles, they like to come out, and I really enjoy getting out here, and it's good for the soul. When I start going with music, I find it very difficult to stop, and all the video editing and everything that I do, it's like a never-ending workload, really.
Because I just hit this unbelievable three-part harmony, it sounds absolutely delicious. I just gotta let someone hear it. It's glorious. Is there a sweeter sound than that? So I promised to give you a bit more insight into my next solo album, and I figured why not on this vlog? It's the best place to do it, right? So it's a little bit different. Look how much stuff's going on here. It's just ridiculous. There's just so much going on here. Basically, this is going to be a kind of ode to video game music. It's going to be like a metal slash video game album. I thought I'd give you a little snippet of what I've been working on. Anyway, I'm not going to give too much away, but it's a hell of a lot of fun, I can tell you that. My good friend Beth, God bless her, about a year ago she lent me this air conditioning unit. In fact, most of the things in this room are borrowed, by the way. That keyboard's borrowed. Everything's borrowed from friends and they just never seem to get them back. I don't steal. They can have them back whenever they want, but I just have very generous friends. I'm very grateful for that. But yeah, R2 over here. Yeah, this is getting me through at the moment, but I had to buy some extra piping, which goes all the way the length of the room. It's quite ridiculous. And then it goes out of the window here. Got this sort of cardboard, and then I cut out a little hole for it, and then this sort of slides in into the window there. So you open it, and then that slides in, the pipe goes out, and basically all the spiders in Australia come through the window, so that's great. Did have a bit of an ordeal yesterday when I found about 1,000 little spiders on the window where I'd left the window open, and I had to go to town. I emptied about half a can of Raid on them, unfortunately. I had to. I've got to protect my family. Do you know what I mean? This is Australia now. We're not fucking about, all right? We're not fucking about anymore. This is deadly shit. You've got to be careful. God, I'm sweating. I need to get iced tea, people. I need to get iced tea. Not the wrapper. I mean the drink. Obviously, Red Thunder. Can't drink that anymore. Red Thunder days are behind me. Do you know what I mean? I did see the devil when I drank that stuff. Unfortunately. So it's very nice to come off the back of a very intense project like the last Moors album and to work on something just that's fun, you know, just pure fun. Can't wait for you guys to hear. I will give you more teasers, but I need to be careful. I don't want to give everything away just yet.
Chris, what are we doing, mate?
We're going climbing.
The climbing gyms have reopened and we're going back. My hands are going to bleed. It's going to be a good time.
Oh, God, there's an open door. It's real.
Hey, there's that crackhead from last time.
It is the same crackhead from last time.
You know, lockdown has not been kind to me. That much is clear. Okay, so there's this really weird dripping noise I keep hearing. I cannot tell where it's coming from. Oh, there's not a leak. I'm terrified that there's a leak. It's coming from in here. It's the washing machine, I think.
Theo, Theo,
what's he doing today?
Lockdown's over and Theo's here! Woo!
Oh, yes! Good to see you, mate.
Like, probably the best part of 6 months.
No, it's been 9 months. The last time I saw you was NAMM, pretty much. A little bit after.
Lockdown's over. We're back!
Welcome to Andy and Theo's cooking show extravaganza.
Yes. Dill pickle chips. Crisps. For anyone in the UK. We don't get those in Australia. Today, we have mustard seeds.
Mustard seeds.
Onion powder.
Onion powder.
Dill leaf tips. It's important you only use the tip of the leaf. If you use the base of the leaf, you will die. Coriander seeds. Ground. Yeah. Not sky. Ground. We've got garlic powder. This is not ground, it's just powder. Citric acid.
Citric acid.
I don't know if we're gonna hurt ourselves or if we're gonna get psychedelic, but something's gonna happen.
Right, but Theo, there's more to this story, isn't there? Because guess what today is?
I forgot!
Yeah, we weren't planning for this.
It's International Pickle Day.
International f***ing Pickle Day.
You need to crush these mustard seeds in the most responsible way possible.
Mm-hmm.
With a knife.
With a big old f***ing knife.
This is the Australian utensil for just about anything.
Yeah.
Cat stuck on the roof? Use a knife. Baby's locked in the car? Use a knife. Need to crush the mustard seeds? Use a knife.
Kangaroos run off with your wife?
Oh my god, no!
Use a spoon?
You flaming galah! Oh, we got one.
See, you've played knifey spoony before.
Step two.
Step two is look at the recipe again. Onion powder is probably gonna be the most delicious thing in the world. I think I'm gonna rub this into my eyes when I'm done.
It's advisable. All right, dump it in. Half a teaspoon. Step five.
Half a teaspoon of dill seed. Well, I couldn't get dill seed, so we just have to imagine that's in there.
But just the tips.
Yeah, just the tips. As we said before, if you use the base of the leaf, you will die, and it is not a pleasant way to die. I tell you
what happens.
You get a full-time job, you start working for much less money than you want. Next thing you know, you've been promoted to manager. Suddenly you're responsible for a whole team of people, and they all do a shit job, and it reflects badly on you. Holy shit, do not use dill leaf.
But then
only the tips.
Okay.
Dill tips.
1 minute of dill tips.
A half a teaspoon of citric acid. I don't know why the hell this is in there.
Dump it in. Dump it in.
Dizzy, I haven't windmilled all year. Ooh.
Tangy?
It's not bad. I think I might need a little bit more dill, but it's getting there. More dill?
Oh, it's tanging.
I reckon that's the citric acid that's given it that tang.
You put too much citric acid in that.
Let's just put more dill in there.
Should my tongue be burning? Did you put more dill?
I put more dill in.
All right.
Ooh, look at
oh,
that.
Oh yeah, there's some...
There's some dill.
Sensual dill
some
going on.
Some dill up in this bitch. Focus.
I think it's a great success.
I think I'd do it without the citric acid.
Yeah, that is actually burning my esophagus.
Is it really?
We're toasting this. I got this for Theo's birthday. This means a lot to us, doesn't it?
This is democracy! Manifest.
If you haven't seen the meme.
This is democracy manifest. Get your hand off my penis!
This guy lives in Sydney. He's real. And he has now brought out his own wine. And we're gonna toast to him tonight, aren't we?
It's possibly gonna be the most important moment of my life.
This is the chap who wrapped me on the penis, people!
Ooh, that was a loud.
Here's to democracy.
To democracy! Democracy! Manifest!
Yeah, do so Super Mario.
I'm really glad of it. How surreal it is to be just hanging out with each other, because it was against the law here in Australia.
Just imagine if you kicked it and the glass pane came out and just fell and just went.
I almost went over this balcony once.
No.
Ta-ta, farewell.
How lovely is this? I love tree ferns.
Have a look at this view. It's Theo's birthday.
Hello, everybody.
We're on a little road trip. We were talking about, hang on, look around, maybe falling off this cliff. So we're all very scared. It's parked up and there's a fucking car down there that has been mashed to pieces.
So it's Theo's birthday. We're going on a bit of a road trip and this is a swervy old drive. But he's got one of these in his car. Break a rub, ducky, come on in over. Break a break coming in hot. It's Greg here. Just checking on the old CB radio, seeing if anyone's all around. Just driving around, seeing what's going on. And hoping somebody's in for a good time. Want to stop over and have a good time with me. I've been on the road for a long time now, so that's me. That's Greg. And hope you're having a good day. Nothing yet.
That was a very long transmission.
It's coming in here hot. Yeah, just realized that was quite a long transmission. I'm sorry if you wanted to say something back there. I should probably give you a little room to come back in. I got some bullshit bikers up here. We're going to get fucked.
We're going to get bummed.
Breaker, just taking a turn here next to those hot bikers. I don't know if you saw them, but if you want to get involved, then, you know, just give us a
heads up. Oh, you dickhead, get off the fucking radio!
And if you look onto your left, you'll see a dead chimpanzee.
Somewhere in the middle of nowhere, there's a sign on this tree that says Mount Joe.
Mount Joe? We're at Mount Joe.
Yeah, come in, mate. What's your 20? They're trying to talk back, but I think the reception's so bad, we're in the f***ing outback now.
I think we've gone back in time. Been driving for a few hours. Have a go at that.
This is some scary shit, dude. Dude, I think we have gone back in time.
This is like some out of a horror movie. Are you trying to open that with your keys?
Yeah.
How many anacondas are we going to see today?
Probably 17.
How about sharks? Great whites?
Ooh,
like
84?
River sharks? 84. Should we partake in a bit of... Do you think I'm getting in that water, mate? You got another thing coming.
We're in the outback. We're in the bush. And we're about to get in by some fucking bull sharks, all right.
Australia, Australia, it's a fucking terrifying place to live.
Now's the time to tell them that there's like crocodiles here.
Fuck me. Is it cold?
I feel pretty alive.
Oh yes, this is living.
We're on the lookout for some sharks. My buddy Theo. Yeah.
Get it, mate. Get it by the cojones.
I can feel the snake wrapping itself around my balls. Fucking strayer, mate. Fucking strayer.
Well, it's the first walk of the year without a mask on. It's pretty amazing. I can feel the wind on my face. You can probably hear what I'm saying. It's just a great day to be... Oh, for fuck's sake.
I'm going to shoot a Children of Bodom cover today. A little bit dubious about how you sit with one of these, because I don't usually... ever play a flying V. You know, like, I guess it's supposed to go. Nintendo Switch in my pocket. Are you happy to see me? Probably just gonna be like this. It's not gonna make for a very cool looking video, is it, if I'm like that? This one burns me. This one burns the tendons out. Fuck me. I never want to play that again.
Floor Jansen, if you're not familiar, is the vocalist of Nightwish. Plex sent me in guns blazing, and I've stripped it. I've redone the piano, been recording some piano, and tickling them ivories today. Yeah, the record label called up Plex. Got a big cigar on. Like, we need you to master this. We need you to mix it up. We need it to go big, Sonny. We need to go big. We need you to do the business, son. We need you to make this thing go big. We gotta make them millions, son, you know? We gotta see it all on the billboards, all over the fucking New York. I'm drinking my coffee. I wanna be hearing the people talking about it. Listen up, Sonny. We got this thing. It's gonna be big, but we need you to make it even bigger. You hear what I'm saying? Anyway, Plek, also, for some reason, smoking a cigar at the time, drops the cigar out of his mouth, looks him straight in the eye. I guess it was over Skype. And he just goes, you know what? I'll get my best man on it. My phone goes off. I pick up. What's happening? What? I'm busy. Can you not call? Don't call me on this number again. I'm about to put the phone down. Wait, wait, wait. Floor Jansen from Nightwish. She needs you. Step up. It's safe to say that Floor was floored by what we've done. Plek made that joke, not me, so you can't get angry at me, okay? I wasn't expecting this today, but I have the singer of Nightwish in my Cubase session. Redone the piano entirely. Do 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 do, let it go. What have I become? I'm arranging a backing track for Nightwish, so I guess it could be worse. It sounded so good. I swear.
hurting so much.
What the fuck just happened?
I can't believe what just happened. I can't believe I didn't have the camera rolling. A fucking kangaroo jumps across the road. Everyone's swerving out of the way. And then it comes back across the road. It hits a Porsche. Kangaroo's fine. Goes back across the road again. The bonnet of the Porsche is smoking. And then as I'm driving off, the kangaroo comes back again right in front of my car. Absolutely fucking mental. I cannot believe I didn't vlog that. I need a dash cam. I fucking love this country.
Hey, hey, how's it going? How's it going? It's sweltering today.
Got old R2 on. I'm gonna turn them off just so you can...
Haven't been able to gig, haven't been able to tour, haven't really been able to do much. This year has been a bitch, but it's our bitch now, all right? We're gonna make it our bitch.
I'm writing some crazy disco metal music.
Oh yeah. A lot of fun, baby!
Metalheads, check it out on Steam. You get like 22 original Andy Gillion songs and an awesome game.
It's gonna be a weekend of drunken debauchery and I cannot wait.
Little cup of beans to start the day.
Exciting! So every mini game has a different song.
Bravery test. I'm drunk. Genital jousting.
What the hell's going on, guys?
I did not consent to this.
This is the other game I'm working on, Brimstone Brawlers.
Oh my god, there's a giant, like, what is that? Is that supposed to be Rudolph?
This lawn, it's so perfectly manicured.
Yeah.
You need to roll on it at your age.
You should roll on that.
I should.
You didn't even break your back. Now, the police are here because Theo started to do rolls in people's gardens.
Andy, I need to go.
Oh, what? What the hell?
I told you they didn't like the rolls.
Merry Christmas, everyone. Let's hope 2021 is better than this shit all year, okay?
The only way I'm gonna get to see my kids again. Hello?
It's been a bad year for Larry. Jack Thomas, Sean, Ben Theobald, Alexander Orff, Kowalski, Miku, Jim Britton, Edward! It's the 2021, bitches! 2020 can go suck itself! Good night, see you on the next vlog, alright.
I've given up bread. Given up bread. Yeah. Maybe you'll see my kids again. It's been so long.
I'm not crying, I just got something in my eye.
Beginning of February, it's pissing down with rain outside. I just got some news, just got a message from Matt Heafy, no less. And he said he's gonna write a guest solo for my new album, live on his stream. And that made me happy, hit the music. Don't shake your body, baby, do that conga, no, you can't control yourself any longer. Come on, shake your body, baby, do that conga, no, you can't control yourself any longer.
And that's more or less how I feel via interpretive dance.
I was also invited by Andy to do a guest solo on his solo record. We could also track that today during stream.
There he is!
The Andy Gillion. I'm thinking very carefully though with this solo because you've told me the other people that are on it and there are some freaking shred gods on the record. The song is freaking awesome. The song's freaking awesome, man. I love the song. It reminds me of like a video game character. So I think we got the whole theme. I don't know if this is what you wanted for a solo, but there it is. This is Andy Gillion's riff off Andy Gillion's upcoming solo record. Andy, you need to, when you post about this, please post that picture of you and I from like, how many years ago was that? Andy, that picture is incredible. What, how old were we? So you were probably like 16, I was like 18 or something. That's amazing.
I'm doing something a little bit different today. I'm doing a cover. This is what I've got going on to try and keep the neighbors from calling the police.
Yeah, yeah.
Anyway, you get the idea. Battery by Metallica. Gonna give it a go. In the band I was in before I joined Shadowlaw, before Moors, I was in Shadowlaw, and before that I was in a band called Later Rest. We were about 16. And they had me doing aggressive vocals, I mean like screaming, but I never really knew how to do the proper fry scream, so I just did it from the gut, you know. I was really just singing very hard, kind of like Rob Flynn. I remember doing a gig and I had tonsillitis and I was pretty much coughing up blood. These guitars though tracked so tightly. Throw it in the hole. Using the Audio Technica 804040, which is an awesome bike. It's an awesome bike. You can ride this one to work. Front suspension, disc brakes, 28 gears. It's everything you need in a bike. Excellent microphone. We create the battery, mashing through the boundaries, lunacy has found me. Yeah. All right, let's get some warm-ups going. La 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 la. Yeah! Yeah! Hetfield in the house. Powerhouse of energy! Oh my god. Hetfield. Circle of destruction, hammer comes crushing. Whipping up a fury, eating a McFlurry. Whipping up a fury, dominating flurry. I need to take it from we create the battery to we create the battery. Smashing through the boundaries, lunacy has found me. Can I kill the battery? Can I kill the battery? Battery is found in me, yeah. Me, yeah. Today's gonna be the day that I'm gonna fucking break a string. With enough processing, we're gonna make this fucker sound awesome. Cutting out some of those nasty mids, a little notch here for that bright kind of punch. Bright punch, and then it doesn't really need anything. The original's quite dark. Look where I am.
Time?
They're just mopping up bugs. All these beetles on the floor over here, they're just hitting these lights. Falling on the floor, they're falling on us. And they're just vacuuming bugs up. Australia never ceases to amaze me. Look at the bugs.
As the race to trace the virus continues,
they made the most of their last few hours out.
Back into lockdown, baby.
Ready for the big reveal?
Whoever's behind me is getting some sort of reveal right now. All right, they're on to a degree. Hey, we made it. Stopped raining for a second and we came to the beach. So we're gonna get in, we're gonna do the thing. I forgot the crocodile, but I've got the frisbee. Oh. I don't actually usually sleep in here.
Come to me, it's on the original!
Don't eat bread anymore. It's 6 weeks now. Really starting to feel the benefits as my New Year's resolution. Give up bread, get ripped as f*** and get them kids back. All right, Larry out. See you on the next vlog, people.
All right, that's enough of this. Let's get on with the vlog.
Happy April, everybody.
I hit up my buddy Samus, and it's a yes. We are going to get married. No, it's a yes. He's going to be on my album, my new solo album. Shouldn't be telling you that, actually. That's not... I think that's really knowledge I want to give away just yet, but I'll put it in the vlog anyway. As I say, you guys are going to get all the information earlier than anyone else. That's why you're on my Patreon. It's one of the perks, right? I'm going to give you these updates. I am currently bouncing the tracks with drums and without drums, then the MIDI of the drums on their own, and then the tempo track. Send it, bundle it all up, send it over to Canada where Samus is going to track the drums. You know, musicians that I look up to. One in particular, I cannot believe I managed to get on this album. Playing 6 or 7 hours of guitar every single day. It screwed up my wrist. I don't know if many people know that I'm a drummer. I played drums for a number of years. But I always had those underlying problems and the RSI problems come back. Rock climbing really helped. I looked good back in the day. Let myself go a little bit during Neverafter, actually. Neverafter, sort of, all I did was just, I worked my ass off in a shitty 9-to-5 job. I don't know if anyone knows about that. This is a huge update. I have a fucking album right there, Neverafter. While I was writing that and recording that for 3 years, I just moved to Australia. Some of it was written in the UK, most of it was written in Australia. When we moved to Australia, we took all our savings and we plowed it into renting some flat, and I ended up getting a really, really bad IT job. I don't know if I've told anyone this. So during the writing of Neverafter and the recording of Neverafter, driving around all over Melbourne from hospital to hospital.
Just on my way to work, didn't have time for breakfast this morning, so I'm just eating dry music out of a bag. That's how I fucking roll.
And I was setting up computers, right? A psych ward where I had to go down into the basement and there were some very dangerous patients.
Jesus Christ. No, don't close on me, don't close on me.
Is that blood stains?
Banging on the glass, were coming right up to me and like asking me if the computer was for them, and like I was very, very scared a lot of the time at that job, honestly. I can't do this anymore. I'm going to America on tour for 6 weeks. I won't be coming back. And that was that. So we did the American tour with the band, and then when I got back from that, it was crunch time. It was like, this is it, Neverafter or nothing. Finishing at like 8 p.m. I'd go home, I would then fire up Cubase and try and do some of Neverafter for like a few hours. I'd never get to see Ananda. And then I would go to bed and I would be too stressed to sleep. I'd be up all night thinking about the music. I'd have like 2 or 3 hours sleep. I'd get up at 6 and I'd do it all again. And it was constantly like that for 2 years, and it was awful. And when finally Neverafter comes out, it was this huge moment for me, because it was like, I've arrived. I have a product. I suddenly have the opportunity to just do this as a career and write music perpetually, keep churning out music for people who want to listen. You guys are making all this possible for me. I literally could just sit here for hours thanking you in every vlog, in every post, and I try not to do that because I know it's just repetitive, but you know how much it means to me. All right, I am on the way to the chiropractor.
Chiroprac! It broke my back! I don't know, it's all out of whack, baby! Let loose! From the noose! Ah, yeah.
Road to M3.
You might have to sort my throat out while he's there. Fucking hell.
I'm terrified. Was the added bonus of picking the worst underwear possible to wear for an x-ray on your hips. And she gets me to lie down, and I'm like, oh, should I take my shorts off? She's like, yeah, take them off, lie down, pull my shorts down. And I'm wearing like the most loose fitting boxers, and I lie down and I'm like, everything's gonna fall out, everything's on show. She's stood over me, she's looking down, she stands by my feet, so she's like, she's got not only a bird's eye view, but she's looking in as well. It is embarrassing, and I'm just like, why did I not think this through? And she puts her hands on my knees and starts pulling. Now subconsciously I know what's going on down there, so I think I started to fight that, and as she's pulling, I think I was pushing back in. So this woman is stood over me pulling my knees apart, just basically unveiling Everything. Now, I haven't seen the x-rays yet. Maybe we'd do a little unboxing video of my hips.
It's the unboxing video of the x-ray of my hips.
Never before seen. I bet you didn't expect to get this on the vlog. That's my ball sack. That's my penis. They spelt my name wrong, which is a bit upsetting. I'm not going to lie to you. This is probably the strangest thing I've ever done on camera. But here we are. I don't mind showing you that. You've paid for this content. It's as good as OnlyFans, isn't it, really?
Are you filming?
Yep.
Right, we're fucking pissed up. I'm with fucking Orpheus Amigo and for some reason, fucking Ryan.
Hello.
And we're gonna fucking, we just found a fucking union.
To be fair, that's about as much pride we have in us.
What the fuck?
It's a part of the flag we don't want.
It's a rug. Fucking cheese it, right?
Can I bring the flag? I'm fucking bringing the flag, boys.
Is that made of like hemp?
It's really wet.
The swooping is so bad in Australia, people actually die. Kids have their eyes pecked out by birds. So bad that they even made a website for it,
which is the official government site. There's a map and people can input the data of where they've been. Young magpie swooped 12-year-old, landed on his head and then scratched his eye with its claw. Cannot make this shit up. Wearing all black and carrying a white bag, the magpies probably thought you were one of them. Attack from my back and above. Injured, yes. I mean, magpie attacked on my right-hand side, left me with a cut and bruising, then re-swooped me. It will do that. And my cycling buddy multiple times. This shit is fucked. My wife was walking, one magpie swooped and hit her under the eye. She has a small lack of eye as a result. What's that mean? Did the chick take a chunk out of the eye? Lost all faith in magpies? What faith can you have in a magpie? She was actually pretty upset. Of course she was. She's had her eyes bitten out by a magpie. I don't understand. People cycle with cable ties hanging up erect from their helmet as some sort of deterrent, spiky deterrent against these magpies. Pecked on the ear and then returned immediately and did again. Some good bloodshed. Got attacked while biking near the intersection of Butterfly Boulevard. Second time it swooped, I was trying to escape out of the area. Got swooped and hit three times with tennis ball-like impact. Very aggressive eye and ear hospital visit. Abrasion to the right eye. This is scary. She was pecked next to the eye and was bleeding heads up. Two hard swoops, the second drawing blood close to the eye. Got off my bike and had a good 1 minute stare out with him. What, you maniac? Cross the road watching my every move. This could be my favorite website.
McDonald's Monopoly is back, baby!
Yeah! Let's play Macca's Monopoly! Here we go. Gotta peel them off. What will you win? Will it be a hash brown or will it be a car? Should I write a jingle for this? What would the jingle be?
Gotta peel them off. What will you win? Will it be a hash brown or will it be a car? You never really know with Macca's Monopoly. But you're guaranteed to probably win nothing.
Now it's Maryland Ball Station again.
Booyah! Peel it to win it, guys. Come on. Oosh! You hate to see it. Pencilville Road. Everyone, Pencilville Road there. Leicester fucking Square. I think this might be a scam. Small soft drink, back of the net. That's shit, isn't it? That's one of the worst ones. The small soft drink, you don't want to get that one. You want to get the car. Chance car, this is a fucking chance car. There's just got to be a car in here somewhere.
What do I do? Swipe. What are you telling me to do here? Oh,
unlock the chest. What could be inside? Cheeseburger or sausage and McMuffin? Thank you, please. Is it egg McMuffin? No, it's just a normal McMuffin. All right, that's a bit disappointing.
Barry.
Hi. No. Hi. No. Is this the birthday thing? Yes?
What?
Okay.
Who's got the music? There. How has he got that?
Freddie Bergstein. I am Larry's brother. He asked, happy birthday!
The bread, I've only just seen the bread! The bread on the fucking keyboard! There it is, he's got it!
It's done. It's real. It exists. I said I'd stop thanking you, but I just want to say another massive thanks to anyone who bought this album. Really, anyone who even just streams it, or listens to it and appreciates it, or drops a comment or a like on something, it all goes a long way. And all I ever wanted as a young musician was someone to play music to, and someone to write music for, and that's you guys. And I really will forever be grateful. Super appreciative of you guys for supporting me on Patreon. It really really helps. I can't tell you how much this is helping me to just live and carry on doing what I love to do. Thank you for being my audience and appreciating my music and allowing me to bring you more. The next solo album from me, that's not far off now. And I'm already starting to think about the next one as well. So hopefully in the near future, it's just going to be album after album after album. I'm just going to keep on going, keep writing more music for you guys. It's an absolute joy to have someone on the other end to listen to the music I'm making. So thank you a million times, a gillion times over. Love you guys. See you on the next vlog, guys.
The Patreon exclusive monthly fucking vlog is filmed in front of a live studio audience. And now over to your host, Larry Bergstein.
Yes, I will have a refund. I asked for highlights. You made me look ginger. How are my kids ever going to respect me? As a Beth, introspective, that's not your real name. Brian, Octavius, something in Russian. Again, Edward, I think it was. Thank you, and good night. I'd like to start by thanking Lassie Blom and Uli Luntanenti and Brittany Scott and Dan and Benek Shek, yeah. Arnold, Sebastian, Anthony, Henrik, Matsi, and Gary Gear, and Theobald chilling up now, Tolga, Ulas, Dennis, and Maxime, Alexa, oh, yeah. Simganic Bulls and Rico too, Volko, Domenica, Bibi as well, Michael, and thank you for spending our time, not Jojo, Biobala, Kaith, Joey, Colin, Shouts, Metal BK, these are not getting any quicker, Daniel, Callan, Dan, Beth, Into Perspective, that's caught some time, but let's do this. Into Perspective, Psycho something, Jacob Bryan and something in Russian, I believe it's pronounced Timo. Yeah, yeah. Oh boy.
I think we got it, guys.
That was actually the first take. It's quite impressive.